adore.
Which just goes to show that sometimes, given even the smallest gift, like a kiss, can turn out to be
okay.
The end.
Oh, no. That is not the end. The end is when you take that yucky book and leave.
Oh, Oscar, you have no taste. Come on.
I never heard such a terrible story in my life. I'm going to go wash out my ears with soap. Oh, yuck, yuck, yuck.
Hello there, and how are you today? I'm here to show you the letter K. And this is the word kitten. Kitten begins with the letter K. This is a kitten. Do any of you have a kitten? Did you know that the kitten's mother carries her kitten by the scruff of the neck?
Meow?
Banana! Watermelon! Peach! Grape. Cantaloupe. Papaya. Grapefruit. Pineapple. Strawberry.
Once there was a man who hated frogs.
I hate frogs. It's a good thing I don't see any.
And on his land, he had a stream.
This is my stream with no frogs.
But the man didn't know that there was a frog in his stream.
Who's that?
And another thing the man didn't know was that frogs eat flies.
Aha! A frog! I hate frogs, so go away!
And so the poor frog left. Soon afterwards, a fly came to the stream. At first, he was afraid there might be a frog waiting to eat him. But there wasn't. So the fly told his friends it was safe. And they told their friends. And soon, there were flies all over the stream.
Hey! Where'd all these flies come from? I see. Frogs eat flies. Little frog, I'm sorry. Please come live in my stream again.
And when the flies saw that the frog had returned, they left. And so the man learned to like frogs.
I did not. I still don't like frogs. But, they're better than flies.
Doodly bum, ba doodly doodly boom ba da bum. Boom, 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 ba doo doo.
Do you hear that beat?
Doodly bum, bum, bum.
Makes you leave your seat.
Ooh, dee da.
Makes you move your feet.
Oh, yeah.
That's everybody's song. Makes your fingers snap.
Doodly doodly dum.
And your hands can clap.
Boom, ba da bum.
And your feet can tap.
Bop, bop.
Come on and join along.
Mrs. Boomba.
Get an itchy ear.
Only itch, itch, itch.
Every time I hear.
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody's song.
Doodly bomba dumba doodly dee dee da. You put the bomba daddy. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Beat.
Doodly 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 doodly.
Feet.
Doo-wop, that's everybody's song.
Secret word for today is explore, yeah. Follow Elmo.
Elmo, are you talking to me?
Oh, no, Elmo not need Susan yet.
Oh, okay.
Explore means to look at something and find out what something is like. Yeah, you can explore, jungle, yeah. With lions and tigers and bears, oh my! Shh! Or you can explore a playground, yeah, with children playing ball, yeah. Or you can explore Susie, yeah, follow Elmo. La 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 la. Oh, yeah. Sometimes when Elmo explore, he likes to make exploring music, yeah. You can do it too. Follow Elmo. La 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 la. Susan reading something. No. She's writing something, yeah. Oh. And Susan sitting. Yeah. Now Susan getting up. And Susan going away. Oh. And leaving Elmo to say, Elmo's secret word for today is explore. Yeah, explore. La 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 la.
You know what I'm doing with this letter H? Let me show you. With the letter H, I can make words like hat and horse. And H can make me feel like a hero. Whoa! Easy. Another H word is hold.
How about heave?
My name is Edith Ann, and I am 5 1/2. That is this many and a little bit more. And yesterday I made a sandwich, and I will tell you about it. First, I took 2 pieces of bread, one for each side, and I put mustard on one of them and peanut butter on the other one. Then, I took some lettuce and some pickles, and I put them on the piece of bread that had the mustard on it. Then I put on some raisins that I got out of a little box. A lot of them fell on the floor, but a lot of them went on the bread, too. Then I found some salami and a big piece of cheese, and I mashed them down on top of the other stuff, and they stayed on there pretty good. And you know those twisted-up things that have salt on them that are called pretzels? Well, I put a couple of them in there, too, and some tuna fish and a black olive. And some oatmeal I didn't eat for breakfast. Let me think. And then I took the other piece of bread and I put it on top and I squooshed everything together under a big, heavy book that is called a dictionary. And a lot of stuff came out of the sides and made funny-looking marks on the tablecloth. But most of it stayed in there okay. Then I put the sandwich on the floor and I called Buster, he's my dog, who I made the sandwich for. And he walked around the sandwich and he smelled it a couple of times. Then he looked at me sort of funny and I said, go ahead, Buster, and taste it. But he didn't want to, so I tasted it myself. And he was right, it tasted terrible. So I took it apart and I put everything back where it was. Only I got some oatmeal in with the cheese and peanut butter on the salami. And I couldn't find all the raisins. And I ate the pickles. And my mother was very unhappy when she saw the stuff on the tablecloth. And she asked me what I did, and I told her. And she says, I can't ever make sandwiches again until I am 6. But that's okay, because Buster and I are going to use a telephone and just call out for pizza. Buster likes pepperoni with double cheese, and so do I. And that's the truth.
What if I were as small as my kitty? And my kitty were as big as me?
Touch, hold, feel, get to know about, reach, find, real, throw away the doubt, close to so much wonderful. See it there, inside, don't hide it. Touch, hold, feel, nice things go with you. Reach, find, real, don't you know it's true? Be afraid, your heart is closed, and your hands in your pocket or your glove. So reach, touch, feel, find, love.
That's right. Yes, if you need a job, just come over and I will help you get one. Come in. Goodbye.
What?
I say come in.
Me?
Yes.
Thank you, sir. It's a highly attractive office. Oh, sir? Sir, my name is Grover.
Haven't I seen you someplace before?
Well, I am presently employed down the street as a waiter at a little restaurant.
Oh, yes.
But I would like to get a new job.
What kind of a job?
I would like to get a job as a lifeguard.
As a lifeguard?
Yes, sir.
Well, do you know what you would have to do as a lifeguard?
Oh, but certainly, sir. As I see it, I sit on a big, tall chair so I can see everybody.
Yes?
Yes, and I make sure they are safe. So if I see someone maybe running where they might slip and fall,
yes,
I blow my little whistle and I yell, slow down! That's what I yell.
Yes.
But if I also see maybe, two little children about to bump into each other, I blow my whistle, and then do you know what I say?
What?
I say, watch out!
Yes. Well, you certainly seem to have the lungs for the job.
Oh, thank you, sir. And I also have my own lifeguard equipment. I have my little lifeguard whistle around my neck. I have my lifeguard hat. I have my lifeguard sunglasses. And most important, I have my lifeguard nose guard. That is so the sun does not burn my cute little nose.
Yes, you do seem to know what to do.
Thank you, sir.
But the head lifeguard will have to check you out. You can go on down to the pool.
Oh, thank you, sir. The pool. The swimming pool?
Of course. A lifeguard's job is to watch all the swimmers in the swimming pool and to dive in and help them out if they need it.
Well, then, I think I will need one more thing to do the job right.
What's that?
Swimming lessons.
almost ready. My greatest invention. With only three simple working parts. This straight piece here, and another straight piece here, and this cross piece between them. All right, everything is ready. My great masterpiece is about to be invented. Stand back, I'm throwing the switch. It works. It works. My new invention works. But wait, it has to have a name. I know. I will call it capital H. Yes, capital H. And I will use the H in words. Oh, how perfect. Now, let me see. Since the H is heavy, I use it to start the word heavy. And of course, the H is very handsome, so I'll use it as the first letter in the word handsome. Oh, what a great invention, this H. Oh, it's absolutely perfect, it's useful, it's controlled, capital letter H. Well, maybe it could use a smidge more work. Come home, H, come home!
Mm-hmm. Yoo-hoo! Hello, hello, Susan. Hello, hello, Miles.
Say hi, Gladys.
Hello. Oh, he is growing, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Sure is. Has he started to talk yet?
A little bit.
Yeah, he says quite a few words now.
Mm-hmm. Oh. You want to hear him read his book?
Sure.
Mm-hmm. What's this?
What is that, Miles?
Come on, Gladys.
Doggy, say doggy.
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 Oh, that is lovely. Oh, you know, that takes me back. Back to my baby cowhood days in the barnyard. I was just a calf then. Mm-hmm. Oh, I was learning to talk. You know, I'd like to sing a song about it.
Oh,
and don't
really?
Be shy about joining in if you feel the urge.
Oh, that'll be nice.
Sure.
I remember the first word I said. Mom was putting me to bed. As she mooed me off to sleep, I said something that I heard from the sheep. I said, ba.
Ba, ba, ba.
Yes, indeed, I said ba. Other cows started gawking. Mom said, at least she's talking. Then she said, baby, say it loud. Say it loud, 'cause I feel proud. I said ba, ba, ba.
Ba, ba, ba.
I remember the next word I said. Mother Goose was being red. Just as Mom came to the end, I said something that I learned from a friend. I said, quack.
Quack, quack, quack.
Yes, indeed, I said quack. Mom felt very lucky, though her girl spoke like a ducky. Then she said, baby, say it loud, 'cause I feel proud. I said, quack, quack, quack.
Quack, quack, quack.
I remember the third word I said. I think I was being fed. When Mom said, drink up, my child, I said something that made her go wild. I said, oink. Yes, indeed, I said oink. She danced a little jig, though her baby cow spoke like a pig. Then she said, baby, say it loud, 'cause I feel proud. I said oink, oink, oink.
Oink, oink, oink.
She said, say it loud.
You said it loud.
Say it loud. When you feel
proud.
Small K. Kiss. Kiss.
Quack, quack, quack.
Kiss.
Hey, Ernie?
Yes, Bert?
Is there a draft here? I feel very cold.
Oh, you feel cold, Bert?
Yeah.
Oh, well, just a second, Bert.
What?
Wouldn't want you feeling cold. I'll get something so that you won't feel cold any longer. Just a minute, Bert.
Wait right there.
Oh. Oh, okay.
Here you go, Bert.
What? What's that?
This is a little shawl.
Yeah?
My grandmother left it here last time she was
coming. When she was visiting. This is your grandmother's shawl?
Now your shoulders won't be cold anymore.
Oh, it's okay, very Bert? Nice. Bert? Thank you, Ernie. Yeah. Oh, where's my book now?
Here you go, Bert.
What?
Lean over a second.
What do you want?
This is earmuffs, so your ears won't be cold. Okay, Bert?
Oh, Ernie, the shawl's enough.
There you go.
I'm not that... Mm-hmm. Hey, Ernie?
Bert.
What?
Here's something else you need.
What?
This is a hat. So your head won't be
Ernie,
cold.
I don't need
bend
a hat.
Over. Bend over, Bert.
Hey, leave me alone, Ernie. What are you doing? Ernie.
There we go.
Ernie.
There.
Where are you?
Can you see, Bert?
No.
Just a second. Let me fix it for you. Peek. Okay? How's it?
Fine.
Good, all right.
But I don't want it.
Well, what else do you
Ernie,
need, Bert?
I don't need anything else.
You need a coat. That's what you need, Bert.
I want my book so
a
I can
nice,
read.
A nice, warm,
Ernie,
fuzzy coat,
Ernie.
Bert. So that nothing,
Ernie,
no part of you will feel cold.
Ernie,
okay,
you're
Bert?
Going bananas. I don't need this.
What else do you
I'm
need, Bert?
I'm trying to read. I don't need. I
you need
my,
a muffler, Bert.
I need some peace
That's
and
what
quiet.
You need. A nice muffler.
Ernie.
So that your neck won't be cold either. Okay? How's that, Bert? How do you feel now, Bert? I can't hear you, Bert. I can't hear him. Oh, just a second. Here, Bert. How do you feel now, Bert?
I feel hot. I feel broiling hot.
Oh, you do? Well, just a second, Bert. Wait right there. I have just what you need.
Ernie, where'd you go? Ernie?
Here's what you need, Bert.
What are you doing?
This is an ice bag.
An ice bag?
Yeah, here. Hold on to it there,
my
Bert.
Chest? What are you doing?
Now let me open
Ernie,
the window, Bert.
I don't need a window.
Here we go.
Ernie, leave me alone.
Okay.
Ernie,
now suppose I turn on the electric fan here, Bert.
No! I'm getting out of here.
Okay, Bert. Okay, Bert?
Ah!
How's that, Bert? Feel better now, Bert?
Leave me alone!
Is my favorite toy.
Hello, Mrs. Kendall.
Hello.
Hi, I'm Dr. Webb.
Nice
how are
to
you?
Meet you, Dr.
Is
Webb.
Is this Megan?
Yes.
Hello, Megan. How are you?
Good.
How did you hurt yourself?
I fell off my bicycle.
Mm-hmm. Did you hurt yourself anywhere else?
No.
Okay. Point to me where it hurts the most.
Right here.
Right there. Okay. Let's examine you, all right? Could you make a fist for me? Very good. Does that hurt?
A little.
A little. Now, extend your fingers again for me. Very good. Very good. Now, close your eyes. Can you feel me touch you?
Mm-hmm.
What about this finger?
Mm-hmm.
And here? Can you feel that?
Yeah.
Very good. Now, just relax. Now I'm going to examine where you told me it hurts the most, okay? Well, Mrs. Kendall, it could very well be fractured. We'll just have to take an x-ray to make sure.
Hey, Megan, put your palm up like that for me. That's it. Okay, and just move over a little. Fine. Okay, don't move, Megan. That's it.
Well, Mrs. Kendall, it looks as if Megan has broken her wrist, right here. We'll reset it, and she'll be in the cast for 6 weeks. Megan, it's time to put the cast on, okay? Okay, you hold as still as you can, all right? Now, Megan, the final layer is the plaster itself. I'm going to apply it wet, but then it will quickly become hard so that you won't be able to move your wrist. Then it will heal. There, Megan, all finished. Okay, wiggle your fingers for me. All right, bend your hand. Very good. But most importantly, Megan, don't get the cast wet. Come back in a few weeks and we'll take the cast off, take another x-ray, and see how well it's healed. Okay, Megan, we're going to take the cast off now. Ready? Now you can start using it like you used to.
You mean I can go swimming now?
Absolutely.
Hi there. I'm Karen. I'm a kangaroo. Here to represent the letter... The letter K. K begins many words, such as kettle, keg, kick, kiss, kite, and another K word is kitten. How about king and kilts? And now a final bit of advice to all you kangaroos out there. Don't keep K's in your pouch. Ooh, they scratch.
She'll be riding 6 white horses when she comes. How you doing there, Maria?
I'm forgetful.
Yeah.
You remembered.
I did. No, I did.
Okay.
So, how are you feeling?
Well, actually, I'm feeling kind of sad.
Sad? Well, what's the matter? Someone rustle your cattle? No, your cow's not giving milk, right? No. Some bandito been mean to you, right? Well, don't you worry, partner, because old Forgetful Joan will ride to the rescue.
No, Forgetful, that's not why I'm sad.
No?
No. You see, my mother was going to come visit me from Puerto Rico, and, I've really been looking forward to it because I haven't seen her in a long time. But then she called and said she couldn't make it. So, I feel sad because I miss her.
Yeah, I know just how you feel.
You do?
Yeah. You see, it was a cold winter's night. Clementine had to go visit her Aunt Bambi in Beulah Falls. And Buster, my horse, went with her because, he gets on real well with Aunt Bambi.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And you know what?
What?
I forgot to go with them.
You didn't.
I did. Yeah, there I stayed all alone. Just me and the falling snow.
Oh, Forgetful.
I felt so lonely and sad.
Yeah.
Oh, real sad.
Oh.
Why, shivering gizzard, I'd do anything to help you from feeling that way.
Well, actually, Forgetful, I do feel a lot better. You've made me feel better.
I have.
Sure.
How'd I do that?
Well, just by being here and talking to me.
Oh, gee, what do you know? It's out of the Wild West, that great old cowboy. Forgetful Jones.
Right.
Saves the day again. Yee-haw!
Yee-haw!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One, two, three, let's see them all on the screen. How many
peas?
1, 2, 3.
3 crocodiles?
1, 2, 3.
3 eggs.
1, 2, 3.
3 little pigs?
1, 2, 3.
3 birthday cakes.
And now it's time for your favorite reunion show. Here is your life. And here's your favorite show's favorite host, Guy Smiley.
Hello, this is Guy Smiley, and I'm hidden in this trash can because I'm about to give someone the surprise of their life. That's right, 2102 Shady Lane, here is your life!
Yes! Surely you don't mean me.
Yes, yes, we do, 2102 Shady Lane. And you wouldn't be standing here today if it weren't for our first guest. Listen to this voice.
I remember 2102 Shady Lane when she was just an idea in my mind. And then I drew a picture of what I wanted her to look like.
No.
Yes.
It couldn't be.
It could, and it is. The man who decided what you were going to look like, architect Frank Lloyd Left. Come on in. Yes. Wonderful.
Hello, 2102 Shady Lane.
Hello, Mr. Left.
Tell us, Mr. Left. Whatever gave you the idea for making a house look like that?
Beats me. I just started doodling, and there she was. Hmm. 2 bedrooms, 1 bath, living room, dining room, kitchen, and oh, the cutest back porch you've ever seen.
Aha! Uh-huh. Well, thank you very much, Mr. Left. Thank you very much. We'll see you at the party afterwards. 2102 Shady Lane.
Yes.
Once the architect's drawings were finished, you were ready to start being built.
Yes.
Can you recognize these voices?
I saw 2102 Shady Lane grow up brick by brick.
Me too.
I don't believe it.
Well, believe it, because here they are, the people who built you, Mr. Bricklayer and Ms. Carpenter. Come on in. Wonderful, wonderful.
Guy?
Hi.
I found a picture of 2102 Shady Lane when she was just being built.
Oh, look at that.
I want to tell you, I lay down every last brick on her.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw him do it. And I lay all the wood. I put in all the wood, the floors, the windows, the doors, and 2102 is still standing.
Yes, she is.
But right now, I wish I could sit down.
Oh, well, thank you all very much. And then we'll see you at the party afterwards. All right. And so they finished you, 2102 Shady Lane. And then the day came when you were ready to be lived in. And a family moved in. They had a little boy and a little girl.
We made our first mud pies in your yard.
And we broke many of your windows with our baseball.
Oh, dear. It can't be.
It is. Please welcome little Tommy and Sally Wilson, now grown up and with children of their own. Come on in.
Hello.
Hi, 2102 Shady Lane.
Hello, Tommy. Hello, Sally.
Oh, sorry about those broken windows, dear.
Yes, and our muddy messes, too.
Don't even mention it. It was a joy being your home.
Aww.
Well, thank you all very much. We'll see you at the party afterwards.
Thank you, guys.
All right.
Yes, 2102 Shady Lane. The Wilsons lived under your roof for many years.
Yes.
But perfect happiness was not to be.
So true.
The kids grew up and the family moved away.
Yes, God.
And they were not the only ones who did. There used to be a house standing next door to you.
Yes.
She was like a sister to you until she was moved to make way for the new interstate highway.
Yes.
But here she is. We brought her back. Formerly 2104 Shady Lane, now number 1 Main Street on the other side of town.
Oh, this is unbelievable, girl. Simply unbelievable.
Well, it's going to get even more unbelievable, 2102 Shady Lane, because here are Tommy and Betty Lou and Carmen and Paco, who used to ride their bikes through your flower beds. Yes. And to remember this wonderful homecoming, we're giving you, free of charge, a new paint job. And this book of memories, and a lovely charm bracelet. And there'll be a party at the Audubon Memorial Ballroom. Yes, yes. So join us again soon for another episode of Here Is Your Life.
Pick the right letter. Jet. Pick the right letter. Zet. Pick the right letter. Net. Pick the right letter. Wet. Pick the right letter. Zet. Wet. Zet.
Don, baby, wake up!
What?
Don!
Hey, what are you guys doing?
Oh, we're cooperating, David.
Cooperating, huh?
Yeah. I helped Don Baby write a song in the morning when he likes to write songs. And now it's time, I say it's time, it's his turn to help me write a song at night when I like to write songs.
I see.
Oh, okay, baby, hit it.
Huh? What?
Hit it, Don Baby.
Oh, yes.
There once was a dude who was up all day. The nights he had to sleep away. But every time he moved around, he always made the coolest sound. Play it, Don Baby. And so he won't have to play alone.
What?
I'll play along with my saxophone.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Hit it.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters H and K and by the number 3.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Sesame Street.